गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम सूरज अग्रवाल एंड यू आर वॉचिंग योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल गार्डनिंग इज माई पैशन। टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फॉर द फाइव ब्लंडर्स, द फाइव मिस्टेक्स यू डोंट हैव टू डू विद द केयरिंग विद द ऑर्किड्स। सो आई एम टेलिंग यू दैट डोंट डू दिस मिस्टेक्स वाइल केयरिंग दिस ऑर्किड्स, बिकॉज ऑर्किड्स आर वेरी प्रीशियस प्लांट्स एंड दीज आर वेरी डेलिकेट प्लांट्स। सो यू शुड नॉट मेक दिस मिस्टेक्स सो दैट यू कैन ग्रो द ऑर्किड्स वेरी वेल एंड यू कैन गेट बेस्ट आउट ऑफ इट एंड बेस्ट आउट ऑफ आउटपुट फ्रॉम दिस प्लांट्स। सो वॉच ऑन एंड कीप ऑन वॉचिंग। आई एम टेलिंग यू द फाइव मिस्टेक्स यू शुड नॉट मेक विथ केयरिंग द ऑर्किड। सो फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट पॉइंट यू शुड कीप इन योर माइंड दैट अबाउट द सिलेक्शन ऑफ द पॉट्स। So friends, if you are going to select one pot, there should be holes in this pot. If you are selecting one plastic pot or such type pots, any kind of pots, you should have slits in the lateral sides of the pots. Like this, I am showing here, these are the lateral sides of the pots. There should be holes. Otherwise, you have to make hole here, so that the aerial roots here come out. Because here, I see, these are some aerial roots. These needs air. So if you are putting here without any hole, without any aperture, so the roots will get suffocated and the plants will die. So make sure when you are potting a plant, you should have slits in the lateral side slits and the holes, sufficient amount of holes, so that plants should not suffocate. So this kind of plot you have to select. So don't select any such kind of plot without any hole or such kind of pot without any can, without any hole. So if there is without any hole, you should make holes here and then pot the plant. So friends, point number two, that while selecting the potting mix, you have to be very careful about selection of the potting mix. So we are making the potting mix here. So we are using bark and you are using sphagnum moss, charcoal, perlite and cocoa chips. So these five things we have mixed for the potting mix. But friends, don't mix this soil, garden soil, in the potting mix, because the plants are epiphytes and they grow on the stems of the big plants. So say they don't thrive in the soils. So don't use soil as a potting mixture, or don't use any kind of compost, vermicompost or leaf mold or any kind of potting mix, compost in the potting mix. So you can use all these five things, but don't use this soil, garden soil, or any kind of compost in this potting mix. So if you use potting mix, soil in the potting mix, or vermicompost or any kind of compost in the potting mix, then you will be losing your plant. The plant will die. So roots will be suffocated and they will die. So don't use these two things in potting mix. So friends, point number three. While you are going to water the plants, if you are going to water the plants, don't water it from above side. Don't do this. Don't do it the water, because the plants doesn't like water in the leaves or in the corner of the leaves, in the joint of the leaves. They don't like the leaves on the water. So if you leave going to water here, the leaves will be rotten. If you at all want to water it, so you can keep it and have a bucket of water, 3-inch water pot, and you drop it here and keep it for 10 to 15 minutes here, and then keep it out. So the plants will be watered. So don't water from the above, and you should note that there is no water left below in this pot. So if you are doing in the above, from above, the plants will die, the leaves will die, the flower will be totally damaged. So don't water it from above, water it from the below side, and that should be kept here. If you are using sphagnum moss in the mixture, so you have to water it in every 7 days. Or if you are not using sphagnum moss, then you have to water it every alternate day, and just by keeping it below side, this type of watering is necessary. So So this is the watering technique for the you have plants, especially for the Phalaenopsis type of orchid plant, you have the water in this way. Point number four. So don't grow the plant in direct sunlight, because the plants grow in the rainforest area, that is on the stem of the below the canopy of the plant, that is below the foliage of the plant tree. So they are growing in the stems below the canopy, so they don't get direct sunlight. They are used to the diffused sunlight. So if you are trying to grow it in direct sunlight, the leaf will burn. So I am showing you that this type of leaf burn you can find if you try to grow it under direct sunlight. The leaf will burn and leaf will be damaged. If your plants leaves are damaged, your plant will also die. So don't try to grow it under direct sunlight. You can grow it inside the room in artificial sunlight, or if you want to grow in inside the room, you have to keep it beside the window so that the plant can get diffused sunlight. Friends, point number five, if your blooms are over totally, this is the spike of the plant and the spike is free and all the green spike, don't cut it from the below. Don't cut it from below, cut it as maximize as height as possible, because if you cut it here, if the flowers are over, if you cut it here, then the new spikes will emerge out from here. So you will be getting the max from this, all these spikes and all the blooms. So if you are cutting here, you have to cut it here just at the time of cutting here. So this is the place where you can cut, and from this node, new spike will emerge in the next 6 months. This will grow 6 months for the dot. Then this will again emerge one new spike and new plant will grow from there and new flowers will bloom here. So don't cut the spikes from the base. So friends, if at all by mistake water falls on the plant, on the leaves of the plant, just wipe off the water, just soak the water with some tissue paper, and just so that no water is left on the plant. So the plants don't like water on their leaves or on their armpit. So you have to remove and wipe off all the water it falls on the plant. So you have to keep care that no water is left on the plant. So friends, don't try to fertilize the plant arbitrarily. So don't use the artificial any kind of fertilizer in it. If at all you have to fertilize the plant, you select one particular for orchid plant fertilizer that is particularly meant for orchid. And if you are using it, you read the instructions carefully, read the doses carefully, then you apply it. Don't use any fertilizer of your own arbitrarily that can damage or kill your plants. So friends, I hope these tips or that I am talking about have become helpful to you for growing or caring orchid. And if you like the video, you please like the video and share with the orchid lovers. If you have some orchid lover friends, you can share the video. Or if you like my channel, so please subscribe my channel. Please subscribe my channel. It will be helpful for growing my channel. So thank you very much. Thank you for watching, and happy growing, happy orchid. Thank you very much.